All right, we're in the studio today. I'm excited to share this creative product shot with you. So whether you're a professional photographer doing this for a client, or you're a creative business owner and you are capturing your product shots in your home studio or in your studio space right now, this is a great technique with a big impact. So it's a water shot. I wanted to go through all the materials first, then we'll grab some photos. Then you can see exactly how to execute this on your own. Okay, so the first thing is the product itself. I just grabbed a shampoo and conditioner in my house, and this was a good scale for the acrylic tray that I'm using for this shot. Now, you want a tray because we're going to be pouring water in here, so we want to keep it contained, but also consider the size of your product. For this is actually a pretty good size. Any bigger, I would really need a bigger tray, and these trays come in so many different sizes, so you can really elevate based on the size of your product. All right, so then we have gaffer's tape, and I'll show you how these come into play, but I have white and I have black. I just wanted to share that depending on the angles and the way that you're positioning your product, since these bottles are white, the white gaffer's tape might make sense. If they were black, a black gaffer's tape might make sense, but we are going overhead, so the tape may not matter in this situation. All right, then we have a blow dryer, which you'll see how that comes into play, and I have 2 cups of water in here. For more of a splash and impact, you may want more water, but we're going to go with 2 cups just so you can see that effect. Now, I'll also be using my iPad, so you'll see the images pop up. Many times, you may be tethered to your laptop, so you can see the images coming through. You can make adjustments if you need to. I will star any of the images that I like the best, and when I download my images from my Canon R5C into Lightroom, those stars, that flag kind of stays with that image, so it'll help me edit down faster. Okay, we are going overhead. You could set up a rig and have your camera overhead, and you could be firing off shots with your laptop or with a trigger system. That's an option, but I wanted to show you, I'm going to be shooting with handheld, plus I'm going to be using the blow dryer. So if you have an assistant, they could be helping you with the blow dryer. If not, it can be done by yourself. Okay, so let's get set up so then you can see this all come to life. Now I am shooting with my 2470 and my 35 prime is always an ideal lens as well, but I'm using this on my other camera that I'm shooting this video on. So we're just gonna go with the 2470 and see what we get. Okay, so there is my Canon. Now I'll go to the Connect app. All right, so now for the setup here. We have a shampoo and conditioner. And what I might do is I'm going to set up an overhead here, just so you can get another perspective of what's happening. This is a scissor arm that I love to use. It's designed for podcast mics, but it is great for our purposes as well. Okay. Take this. Okay, I'm going to plug this in. So this is ready to go. Go. We'll have this. We have the camera. Okay, I just want to make sure you can, when I record this, you can see everything. Okay, so that's recording for us. Okay. All right, so we have the acrylic tray. Now that you see our whole setup here, a little behind the scenes, we have our water, we have our product. This is what we're going to do. We want to position our product first before we actually put the water in. And this is where the gaffer's tape comes into play. So we have a shampoo and conditioner. I'm just going to do the shampoo on the left, conditioner on the right. And because of the nature of these bottles, they're going to roll. We don't want them to roll, especially once we're putting water in and once we're using a hairdryer. So that's where the gaffer's tape comes into play. So I want to position the bottles exactly where I want them to be. So I'm just rolling this up. I'm going to put it to the back of the bottle and then I'm going to position it. Okay, that looks good. All right, so I'm just taking a good little piece off. I'm going to roll this. Gaffer's tape is so good. Okay. And I'm going to place this one maybe a little bit lower here. And I can take it off and replace. I don't want them touching. Okay. That looks, might move this one a little bit. That looks pretty good. Okay, so just so you can see how the iPad is going to work, I am just going to just look at my settings here. I'm going to be at 2.8. I want a little drop off. I'm going to do ISO 500. And just so you can see what I'm seeing, so I can already see that glare of the light. This is the shot without water in it yet. Okay. So the first thing we need to address is this light. We want the light, but we don't want to see it. So what I might do, so as you can see, they're popping into my iPad here. So this light we don't want to see. Okay. So let's try to rectify that. Now this is reflective versus if we just had the product on this backboard. So what I'm going to do is see if by shielding the light a little bit, if that helps block the light. So then we can get our shot. I'm going to pull the tray away a little bit too. Let's see how we're doing here. Okay. All right. So let's try. All right. That light is gone a little bit more. See if we pulled it away from the perspective versus it's over here. Okay. I'm going to push the light away next. So then you can see these are popping in to the iPad. These are the latest shots. So that's still a problem. Okay. So this is what we're going to do. We still need the light. I'm just going to pivot it away a little bit. I'm going to take this out so we can get that light. But now it's not in our way. Okay. All right. So once this is, now I can move it a little bit more. Okay. Let's try this again. So I'm just going to crop. I will probably, as you can see, I'm taking it a little bit wider than the actual shot itself. And what I am thinking of, So I'll show you up here. What I'm thinking of is I'm going to then crop this in once we have that water shot. Okay, so let's add the water and see what comes up next. Okay, I don't want these touching. Make sure they're secure. All right, so here we go. We're gonna pour the water in. All right, the water is in. Let's just grab a shot, see how everything's. Okay, we have our water. This is gonna pop into our iPad. So you really can't tell. So we need that water to be moving to really get that shot. So I'm right hand dominant, so I'm going to shoot with my right hand, okay? And I'm going to use the hairdryer, so this is gonna be loud, on my left hand. And I'm gonna have it on high, and I want the water to move. You could move the tray like this and get some movement. You could do that. But if that's not enough movement, so we'll see it in here. That's pretty cool. We're almost there. That's one way. It almost looks like a wave. But if we want some movement, we're going to do the hairdryer on high. So I'll lower the volume when this section comes up. Okay, here we go. All right, thank you for bearing with me with that. Okay, so we have a lot of good options here. And you can see by the power or the position of the blow dryer, you can get different things. So here, yes, you're seeing the top and the bottom of the tray. This is why the size of the tray matters. So if you really have bigger products, you really want to get a bigger tray. We're probably at capacity here, but I'm thinking I'd be cropping it in so you're not even noticing that. And I think that looks great. Okay, so here's another one. So I'd be cropping it in. I'll probably rotate, but you're seeing that water move again. And it just adds a little something to the shot. You can see all these different. And even if, let me try this, I wanted just to zoom in, so I'm gonna run this again, but zoom in on like, on just a part of the box. You can see how you're just getting that effect with that water. And it can make for a cool like detail shot. Okay, let's just, since we're all set up, I'm just going to show you what a different color background might do. A little experiment. Of this little piece of a darker backdrop. Let's see what happens with a darker backdrop. Okay. All right, here we go again. Okay. So with the darker background, again, if I'm cropping this in, you can see a little bit of a difference. Just a different vibe. They're gonna pop a little bit more versus here's that lighter one. Lots of different options. Okay, since we've gone dark, let's go light just to see for comparison. And we really want to go with your brand's vibe of like if you want light and bright versus dark and moody. Okay, so let's go with the white background. Here we go. Okay, obviously this is hot, so whatever you're shooting, you don't want to be melting or if it's sensitive to temperature. Okay, so with the white background, something to consider, which is something I'm seeing here, is that I will have to edit out that portion of the tray, and same with here. So that'll be an easy edit, but you can see once we crop in, brighten this up, this could be a great shot for the product. Okay, so let's do a comparison with the white, the gray, and the dark, and see which you like, which you prefer. And I will, of course, link the things that I'm using here to the description below. And if this was helpful, I'll also leave a link to a PDF document download that you can research products for product photography and my tips and tricks here for this creative water shot. Okay, let me turn this off. I think we got that covered. And if you enjoyed this video and you thought it was helpful to have your Canon R5C connected to your iPad, I will leave a link to how to do the setup. This has been a game changer on all my shoots when I'm working with brand clients and we're moving from different locations and different setups, and we can have the iPad with us seeing the images in real time. It's such a great boost in the experience for the client, and it helps you make sure that we're all on the same page and happy with the shots. Okay. All right. And I'll see you there.